answered, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength, and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. You have answered correctly, Jesus replied. Do this, and you will live. But he wanted to justify himself, so he asked Jesus, and who is my neighbor? In reply, Jesus said, a man is going down from Jerusalem to Jericho. When he was attacked by robbers, they stripped him of his clothes, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down the same road, and when he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. So too a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, he passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, as he traveled, came where the man was. And when he saw him, he took pity on him. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, pouring on oil and wine. Then he put the man on his own donkey, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day, he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper. Look after him, he said, and when I return, I will reimburse you the extra expense you may have. Which of these 3 do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of robbers? The expert in the law replied, the one who had mercy on him. Jesus told him, go and do likewise. The word of the Lord for the people of the world. Today I want to speak on Christian action. The relationship you have with Christ causes the one-two in you. You know the one-two, be like Christ. Therefore, you want to show others Christ's love. And you do that through your actions. Christian action is representing Christ in his church. In works of compassion. Let's look at our gospel lesson today. And I'm going to look at Luke chapter 10, verses 29 to 37. The Samaritan could have stopped after the bandages, but he went ahead and poured oil and wine. No, okay, that should have just been plenty. But no. He could have said, I did my part, and just went on his way. And he could have said, I even supplied the bandages and the oil and the wine. But did he stop there? No. He put the person in need on his donkey. He took him to the local clinic and dropped him off. Now, just joking, there's no clinics back in that day. He took him to an inn, and he himself took care of the man. Okay. He did more than his share. That should have been more than enough. Don't you think that was more than enough? No, because the person chose to do even more. He pulled out his money. Now you may say, that's asking too much. Too much for me to invest financially. Person did. He cared for the man by himself. Then he paid for further care for the injured person. Wow. That is Christian action. And what did Jesus tell us? Go and do likewise. Christian action is witness to Christ, wherever you may be. See, Jesus tells us we're to be his witness. Christian action is using of gifts to carry on Christ's work. It is making Christ and his love real in the world. So, what should we do? We should give our heart to God. That's one. We should give our minds to God. And what's left? What's left, you ask? Giving of one's hands and one's feet to God. Because Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And he said that in John chapter 14, verse 6. And this is the exact verse. Jesus answered, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Christian action, a life overflowing of God's love for people. Christian action is offering Christ to the world through the witness of your life. Christian action is response to God's grace. God's grace comes to us to enlighten our mind and strengthen us. Wake up! This is the greatest reality of our lives. God's redeeming love. And have you realized that when we have spiritual kinship with God? That's so awesome. Just imagine. I want you to hear that again. We have spiritual kinship with God. And why do I say that? Because he says we are made in his image. Laura. She's coming. you've been given the Holy Spirit. Such a gift. The Holy Spirit lives in each of us. And it's become evident in our lives, the spiritual qualities. Now, Paul calls it the fruit of the Spirit. You've heard of that. Fruit of the Spirit is such as love, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Each is a fruit of God's grace coming alive in us. They are avenues of Christian action. These spiritual gifts given to us are to be used for Christ's ministry.
Sermon.
And here again, it's Jesus speaking. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Do not be disheartened or discouraged by difficulty. Remember that God sometimes uses failure for success. And it all comes in God's own time. And God's time is not our time. Now we have a plan, and we are working it. What's the next step? Superman for the day? No, Christian action is a way of life and is done naturally every day. And by the way, the rest of life cannot stand still while you're doing Christian action. So it goes both ways. Christian action cannot wait until you take care of life's necessities. So it's important to know that Christian action is everyday living. Make it a way of life. Okay, now we have the perspective, so we'll move on from that. Try not to do it all alone. So you're asking, and just where am I supposed to find the help to do this? Few suggestions. Let's start with the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit's with you. The Holy Spirit's available and will guide and will empower the Christian action. Who else can help? There are committed Christians who are willing to join in your efforts. According to Luke chapter 10, verse 1, the disciples went two by two. So we can do that too. Two by two. Another place to find assistance is the church. Your church is your base. The base camp and the fellowship. It's where Christian action begins. Okay, that's enough on help. Now let's talk about how it should be done. Christian action has to be authentic. It must flow from care for persons, not from your own need to be needed. Let me say that again. It needs to flow from care for people, not for our actions. Of wanting to be needed. Christian action needs to flow naturally from your own faith, your experience, and your own personality. Christian action is not to be forced, and it's not preconceived. It just is. Christian action is not to be done with the better than now attitude. Well, I think you get the point on how and the meaning of attitude that you need Sonship is a style of Christian action. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 18 reads, "All this is done by God, who through Christ changed us from enemies to friends and gave us the task of making others his friends also." Reach out to people with whom you naturally come in contact with. Start by making a friend. Take the initiative to get to know the person. Understand that person's life. Understand the situation, their needs. Offer assistance. Listen for what strengths they have. Listen and support. Be that person's friend. Share your life. Be there in tough times as well as good times. Reach out. Offer assistance. And show agape love. Let them see there is living faith in your life. Introduce your friend to Christ. Share with them information about your relationship with a one-on-one with Christ, your life and your love. Your friend will have seen Christ in your life just by you being authentic and natural. Jesus does call us to be witnesses. But not just witnesses, and not only our words, but in our deeds. In 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 1 to 3, it states, "Are we beginning to commend ourselves again, or do we need, like some people, letters of recommendation to you or from you? You yourselves are letters written on our hearts, known and read by everyone. You show that you are a letter from Christ, the result of our ministry, written not in ink, not on paper, but with the Spirit of the living God. And it's not written on tablets of stone, but on tablets in our hearts." Did you hear that? You are a letter from Christ written by the Spirit of the living God on tablets of human hearts. Wow. That is so great. We are from Christ. So make a friend. Be a friend. Be a friend to Christ. Sharing Christ authentically and natural, when we make it part of the everyday interactions and sharing of ourselves in relationships. This process is naturally displayed. Your personality and your spiritual qualities are given you. Besides reaching out to people you naturally come in contact with, reach out to those who need a helping hand. To people you may not even know personally. You are to make God's friendship real to people. Remember the story Jesus told us of the Good Samaritan? Remember also that we are to go and do likewise. Respond to people's felt needs and seek to change the problems that cause the need. Listen. Listen. Who did Jesus listen to? He listened to the very young. He listened to the sick, to the disposed, to the poor, to those who were left out. He asked us to listen. So let's get back to reaching out. Reach out with Christ and grow in God's love towards all. By prayer and study, make action a regular part of your life, a discipline. Don't just wait until you feel moved. Christian actions requires to consider others, to identify those in need, and to do for others what you would want them to do for you. Hey, did you hear that? That was the golden rule. And Jesus tells us that. In Matthew chapter 7, verse 12, Jesus says, "So in everything, do to others what you would have them do to you." For this sums up the law of the prophets, the golden rule. Christian action calls for commitment from us to take up the towel and become a servant in union with Jesus Christ. In John chapter 13, verse 14 and 15, Jesus says, "Now I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet. You also should wash one another's feet. I have set you an example of what you should do as I have done for you." As Jesus did, we are to serve selfishly, selflessness, without concern for results and recognition. We are to learn to be creatively obedient to the God of love. Remember that Christian action is our grateful response to God's awesome grace. Empowered by the Holy Spirit, by which we grow in the likeness of Christ. When you are involved in Christian action, you are authentically living up to the image of God, in which you were created. Your potential for loving God and your neighbor with your whole life. Your mission is to pass the gift of grace you have been given. Christian action is an extension of Christ's work. You know, there's a statue of Christ in Germany that lost his hands during World War II in a bombing raid. So a sign was placed on that statue that reads, "Christ has no hands but yours." God is counting on you. The development of the kingdom has begun in Christ. And we need to share the love to continue that building.